Hello there. My name is Dr. Carlo Oger. I am a board-certified emergency physician since 2003 and the creator of DrER.tv. In response to one of my followers' comments, I decided to make and post this video about the subject on how to study in medical school. You might ask yourself, what makes him, me, qualified to talk about this subject? Well, I had a perfect 4.0 GPA graduating in a bachelor's in science from the University of Puerto Rico at age 20. Yeah, do the math. I started college at age 16. I was summa cum laude. Not so good in medical school. I had a 3.92 GPA and graduated just magna cum laude. But that was enough for me to attain the Alpha Omega Alpha Honor Medical Society distinction in my class. So I guess I know a little bit on how to study and get good grades. But I am no expert. My opinions expressed in this video are just that, opinions. And what worked for me might not work for you. So I encourage you to learn as much as possible about the subject. I found these two books, How to Study Medical School Second Edition and Success in Medical School, when I searched on Amazon.com for content related to this. I am sure that the level of detail and thoroughness of the content is way better than anything I could teach you on this video. I ask that you help support my time and efforts, and if you choose to purchase any of these references, to use the links provided in the description below. The simplest way to answer this question on how to study medical school is the following. Study like you had to turn around and teach what you just learned to a future patient. Can you grasp enough of the content or the concept of what you just studied? Can you make it simple enough to explain to a child, but know enough details to satisfy a stressed mother over the illness of her child? Another perspective you should consider is the following. Do you want to do well in the exam, or do you want to learn medicine? You might think it's the same thing. If you do, you will not do well. The real problem with learning in medical school is that medical school is like trying to drink directly from a fire hose. The sheer volume of suggested and required reading makes the task overwhelming, actually impossible. This was my biggest stressor my first few weeks of medical school. I was just overwhelmed with the amount of information that was being hosed down my throat. So, instead of trying to do it all, you're gonna have to pick what you read and what you study and stick with your plan. You will have to choose what you learn, and then you're going to have to learn it 100%. It is better to know by heart 70% of the material than to kind of know 30 to 40% of the material. This movie, Grey's Anatomy, was released in 1989. I watched it so many times growing up. There's this one scene where the main character shows up in study group after dribbling his basketball or playing basketball or whatever. The rest of the group were freaking out about the upcoming test and how much material they had to go through to be ready for the next day. He was just plain cocky when he told them that he was done studying and he was ready for the test. The group could not believe him. That would be impossible. But he stated that he just studied all the figures and charts in the chapters, as well as the items that were bold. In other words, he skimmed through the material and selected what to memorize. He claimed that this would guarantee him at least 80% of what would be tested on the exam, and getting a B or a C was just good enough for him. Now that's a bold move. I don't think I ever did anything like that, but it exemplifies my point. Choose what to study and then study it well. And while you're skimming through texts and pictures and figures and graphs, ask yourself, will this make a good exam question? If you were the professor, would you ask this in the exam? What would you ask? And how would you ask this? You will be surprised how many times I personally could predict the questions that were going to be asked, and how excited I was when I was in the test and I knew it was coming up and I knew the answer. Now, one other thing to consider is to consider how is it going to be asked. They're not going to give you the definition of this is blank. They often do what's called double questions. You'll have to come up with the answer in your mind, but then it's actually asking something else about the problem. For example, a patient presents with palpitations, episodes of sweats, brittle nails, and weight loss, and feeling anxious. And then they'll say, what medicine could help the symptoms? So they're not telling you the diagnosis. You have to come up in your mind that this is probably hyperthyroidism. And then what is the treatment? Maybe a beta blocker or iodine or whatever the answer is, for example. Medical school is a lot like high school all over again. All the clans and the drama, the peer pressure, and worrying too much what others are doing or studying or claiming that they did not study for the test. Myself, I never cared for the big lecture halls. I would show up and then escape as soon as possible to the library where I had a chance to actually study what I wanted to study. Some of the classes I barely went. Instead, I just was to study and then I went to the library and went through it and taught it to myself. No wasted time listening to things that ultimately are not going to help me in the test. Now let's talk about the paper chase. My class had this thing called paper chase. It is a program by which other students recorded and then transcribed every lecture. Everyone involved took turns doing it to produce massive amounts of paper handouts, adding even more to the volume of material one had to review before the test. What a waste of time. If it wasn't good enough to hear it once in class, why waste your time recording the thing and then transcribing the nonsense? Instead, make friends with the upper classmates. Many of them have question banks or they wrote notes after the test. That will help you predict the questions that are going to come up in the test. Sometimes even show up verbatim. Now that is quality time studying. So, what else can you do to study well in medical school? Well, a recent study found that the Mediterranean diet helps in keeping aging brains sharp, and that growing body of evidence links foods like those in the Mediterranean diet with better cognitive function, memory, and alertness. So don't take this lightly. Eat your veggies. Getting adequate vegetables, especially cruciferous ones, including broccoli, cabbage, and dark leafy greens, may help improve your memory. Be sweet on berries and cherries. Berries, especially dark ones such as blackberries, blueberries, and cherries, are rich source of anthocyanins and other flavonoids that may boost memory function. Get adequate amounts of omega-3 fatty acids. Essential for good brain health, omega-3 fatty acids, or DHA in particular, may help improve memory in healthy young adults. DHA is most abundant fatty acid in the brain, so it makes sense that if you have higher levels of this, DHA, in the blood, then the brain will operate more efficiently. This is literally like gas for a car, but for your brain. Seafood, algae, and fatty fish, including salmon, bluefin tuna, and sardines, are some of the best sources of omega-3 fatty acids. Now, if you're like me, I don't eat healthy at all. And healthy food is expensive. And you might not have enough money to go and buy it at the grocery store and then cook it because you're busy and you have to eat fast food. In this case, consider supplements. For example, Smarty Pants, in the picture, is just one kind of multivitamin you can use to provide you with brain food. Literally. I will place the Amazon link in the description below so you can check it out. Also, work in your walnuts. Well known for a positive impact on heart health, walnuts may also improve working memory, snack on a handful of walnuts to satisfy midday hunger, add them to an oatmeal or salad for a crunch, or mix them with vegetable stir fry for extra protein. Sleeping. When you learn something new, the best way to remember it is to sleep on it. That's because sleeping helps strengthen your memories you formed throughout the day. It also helps to link new memories to early ones. So those sleepless nights studying might not be as productive as you think. I personally never stayed up all night studying. Latest I would go is about midnight, most of the time 10 or 11 o'clock. I would rather wake up early when I was fresh and study then. Lastly, sleep strengthens memory. The non-REM stages of sleep seem to prime the brain for good learning the next day. If you haven't slept, your ability to learn new things could drop by up to 40%. Well, that's all for now. Thank you for spending this time with me, and I hope it was time well spent. Don't forget to comment, subscribe to the channel, and share through social media. This is the best way to show support for the work I did. And, of course, good luck in medical school.